H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
And then check in the Dropbox or the drop-down if you have the address available. Okay, click on the Go button. Yes, click on that Go button. Just wait, do it slowly, okay? And then click on the Authenticate. Login. Okay, just wait for some time, Rohini. It is logging in, okay? Maybe you are logging in for the first time, right? So it will be making some settings. Okay, so do you see, Rohini? You have logged in. Now you can start creating the requirement. Alright. Okay, so next we have Russell. So we don't list the individual steps in the quality center. Do we? Okay, Russell, see, whenever it is a quality center, you know, again, there is not much of difference whatever you have prepared in the RTM, right? The same way you have to list the requirements in the quality center also. Okay, Russell, even in the quality center, in the same way you are creating the requirements, the same description you write, the same name you write, okay, and the same hierarchy you maintain, it's all done in the same way. Okay, Russell, if you have any other questions other than that, please let me know. And Rohini, you can start using this one. Then I have a request from next participant, Shilpa. Okay. I have a question. Vinit is also writing the modified date reviewer in the requirements. You should not write it, Shilpa. Okay? Vinit, please don't write it. So you should not write the modified date and the reviewer. Leave it as blank. It will be filled out when the reviewer is going to review it. Okay? If you are writing it, please don't write it. Then Divya, I was using and I'm not able to view it now. Okay, Divya, I'll make you the presenter. Please show me your screen. Okay? Russell, if you have any more question, you can please let me know. I make you the presenter, Divya. Please share your screen. Okay, Divya, I have unmuted you. So you have got the SkyTab, is it? Okay, do unmute.
Yeah,
click
yes.
on that SkyTab button.
Priya, I was using this until now. Suddenly it went. I don't know what happened.
Yeah, please click on it. Let's check. Okay, so now click on that image that you can see in the bottom. No, not that one. Yes, that image. Please click on that. Just click on the allow.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, go to that SkyTab. What is here? It is mentioned using the Chrome or Mozilla update. So what you do is use it in the Google Chrome, Divya. Do you see that it is mentioned? Please wait for the link and then wait for 5 minutes. Use it in the Google Chrome or the Mozilla. Copy and paste it in the Mozilla or the Google Chrome.
Hello, Priya?
Yes, click on that give permission. Okay, do one thing. He has given you the link, right, to install the Java update?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Click on the Java update and then install the Java update.
I have done this, Priya.
But why it is not logging in?
I was using Mercury also. Suddenly it disappeared. I was just using for Bambino Express currency converter also.
Then you need to check with them, you know, because this SkyTap is maintained by them.
Okay. Like you was, there was a call for you from, there was a request. You just shared that screen and that disappeared. My screen got disappeared.
Okay, so that cannot happen, Divya, if I share others' computer. So nothing can happen to your computer. So what you do is, you know, check if, you know, there is some issue from their side.
Okay.
If it is working or not. Okay.
Okay, Priya.
Yeah. Okay, Karishma, you can share your screen and let me resolve your doubts. Okay, Karishma, I make you the presenter. Please share your screen. Ramona and Srilata have noted. Okay, Karishma, what is your question?
Yes. Priya, I have a question saying that you taught on that day how to copy paste. It's simple like what we do in other, it is in Microsoft, like just we copy this and if I want to paste it, I'll bring it here and I'll say paste. Now I want to paste it as a sibling or just paste, it paste. That's what it was?
Yes.
Okay, so this is done. Now my question is that if I have created anything as a child requirement, so can I later create it as a new requirement or can I bring it under a new requirement?
Yes, you can do that.
So how do I do that? I mean to say,
cut and paste it.
Cut and paste it. That's what. See, if I have in quick user tools, right, in that link, if I go over here in the Bambino Express, see, in quick user tools, we have all these things, what I made it under child requirement. So what I want everything to come under child requirement. Currency converter, then?
Yes.
But this
the
global
locations you want under, one second, global locations you want under quick user tools?
Right.
Okay, so right click on that global locations, cut it.
Okay.
Select the quick cut user it. Tools.
Okay.
And then paste it.
Not just paste it or paste
just
it?
Just paste it.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Is it fine now?
Okay. Okay. So again, like whatever the things are there, so this green thing means that these are under quick user tools. These are child requirements of these?
Yes. Child requirements.
Okay. So the these child requirements always appear in green?
No, that is how it is configured. I mean, that is just a look and feel that is made over there. Okay.
Okay. And again, I have a question, like everybody is asking, what about the no run and not covered? These things, again, I just want to, these things are not clear.
See, no run means never executed. Not completed means it is incomplete.
Okay. Okay. One more question is that, see, when we used to create our RTM for, say, Bombino Express, so we used to do it like that, like valid amount and everything. We used to write everything in detail, right? Enter valid amount. This is my requirement page about the currency converter. Okay. The same thing when I go here in Bombino Express and I open this, so how do we have to write this all in requirements in detail? Where do we have to write? And how do we check the validity, invalid values, blank values?
See, for, you know, the Bombino Express, this is the main requirement, right? So we had written FR001 and under that we had given the description that the Bombino Express homepage opens and all that. So you can write it. Do you see here? This go to www.bombinoexpress main page. So that you can write it over here. And when you try to create it for valid amount, so under that valid amount you can write the description that corresponds to the valid amount.
So everything that we prepared in Excel about, say, considering four conditions, saying for blank, for invalid, valid amount, so that all has to be written in one description?
Yes, in one description.
And even the values that need to be tested, like it accepts only numeric value or it accepts
only see here, value. One second. Karishma, see. One second, okay? Please try to understand. Here it is a Bombino Express main requirement, correct?
Okay.
So under this, you write Bombino Express homepage opens with the URL www. Okay. So that description, you write it over here. Okay. And under this, I think you have created something like quick user tools. So write the description about the quick user tools or yes, our services or quick user tools. So write the description about the quick user tools or let's say our services. Under the our services, these are the services that are available. For example, rates is available and whatever services are available, you can write it for the our services. Okay?
Okay. So we can write as much as detail we want in the description thing?
Yes, same like your RTM. No difference at all.
Okay. So it's like same thing like quick user tools. We enter the URL, then the page gets open. But there were
same
set
thing.
Of steps, right? Same thing.
Yes.
Okay. And how if I have to check valid value, invalid value, that also has to be written?
Yes.
Some for
you
particular
write
page it is.
Same there. Like your RTM.
Okay. Okay. I got it. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Jayashree, I'm making you the presenter. So you can share your screen. Okay, Jayashree, let me unmute you. So go to the start, Jayashree. All programs. Okay, do you see there is a last option, Quality Center? QC Explorer, please select that. Okay, click on the drop down. You don't have the URL? Okay. So do you see that in your Mozilla Firefox there is Suresh8080QCBin? Can you please copy and paste that?
Yes.
Yes, click on the go button now. Authenticate. Okay, enter the user ID and then authenticate.
What username should I use here? Admin.
Alex underscore QC.
And password.
Password is blank, click on the authenticate.
Should we have to use the login now?
User login.
Priya, do we have to start this thing every time with the same procedure, or can we start it directly?
We need to, you know, follow the same steps.
Oh, every time I open this, should I have to follow the same steps?
Let's follow the same steps.
Okay, Priya, I'll do the thing right now in the quality center, and I'll if I have any doubts, I'll ask you.
Ramona, I have made you the presenter. Can you please tell me what your question is? You have the doubts in rearranging the requirements, right? Yes, please show me that one. Yes, tell me what is your question, Ramona.
Okay, I have created Bombina Express, and then below that actually I have written enter amount. I don't want that. Like I want this Bombina Express currency converter to come on top. So how can I do that?
Okay, cut that Bombina Express currency converter, select it and then cut it.
Okay.
Then go to the Bombina Express and then paste it.
No, I want it above the enter amount.
Okay, so cut that enter amount. Select that Bombina Express currency converter. and then paste it there.
Okay, so and here my doubt was like, is this correct? Like below Bombina Express, Bombina Express currency converter, and there's no need of this enter amount, right? Below Bombina Express currency converter only I can write valid data, invalid data and blank data, right?
Yes, you can do that.
Okay, so there is no need of this enter amount.
No.
Okay, so this is correct, my approach.
Yes.
Okay, fine, yeah, thank you.
Okay, in the currency converter page, do we need to create the requirements for inputs and then? Yes, Srilata, you have to create it. Okay. Then when to use the child requirements and requirements? Okay, Divya, when you are creating the main requirement, use the new requirement. Okay, that is the first button. And every time you are creating the child requirement, means except the first time, go for the new child requirement, that is second button. Okay, fine. So in case you have still any kind of doubts, again we will take it up in the tomorrow session, and I will show you one more requirement and then we will go to the next module of the quality center. Okay, so try to practice it today. I have sent you the recorded sessions. Please go through the recorded sessions, and if anybody have the technical issues, please make sure that, you know, they are clarified. Okay. And then we will meet tomorrow at 7 p.m. Eastern again. Take care, everyone. Thank you.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.